So before we dive into this awesome video, it was sponsored by Aniba.com, which is a marketplace where you can purchase game keys for an extremely low price. Now, Aniba.com has been live for about a month or so, but has a ton of users that are extremely happy. Now, of course, you can get things like games, gift cards for your Xbox games and PlayStation, etc. And what's really, really cool is on the weekends, Aniba.com has sales where you can find top games at a really, really low price. Now, all you gotta do is register using my link in the description below in order to get yourself a 1 euro bonus. And even better, if you use my code SUPERREBEL, you will get yourself a 3% discount. So hey, if you want to save your pennies but get some amazing games at the same time, then what are you waiting for? Check out Aniba.com. The link is in the description below. What is going on, guys, and welcome back to another video. So, as we all know, right, because I shared it on my community tab with you guys and I got your thoughts about it, and of course, if you were following the PlayStation event yesterday, you would know about the Marvel Iron Man game, right? But wait for it. It's not just your Marvel Iron Man game, it's VR, okay? And you need your PlayStation VR to be able to play with this stuff. Now, either I am going completely crazy, right? Or basically coming out, and like if I was Sony, right? Me coming out saying that all of that was a complete joke and that we're actually releasing a real Iron Man open world game would probably be the best thing to do in a situation like this. It would make the VR trailer and everything actually look okay. But I shared my thoughts on it as well with you guys in the comments on my community tab, and a lot of people seem to be kind of annoyed with this. And for me, it's like, it's super frustrating because I just don't see why companies are not seeing a market for this, especially after the Spider-Man game. And the reason I mention that all the time when I talk about this kind of stuff is because with new generation consoles, that's pretty much the only superhero game, I guess you could say, that we have had that of course proved that it could be successful. Now, the trailer you guys see in the background, which I will continuously loop, okay, throughout this video for you to pretty much allow it to sink in, looks cool, right? It does look cool, but bear in mind, okay, when you go into these VR kind of games, it's probably gonna be just as long as like the Spider-Man VR game, which was pretty much like a couple of minutes. It wasn't anything drastically long, don't get me wrong, VR I still think is great and all, but I just don't think that it's gonna be as good as if you go back to like 2-3 years ago, we thought it would be. VR, no one really, I guess they don't rock with that kind of stuff anymore. No one really wants to play a game in VR because it can get a little bit annoying, and having a game like this in VR, although it's kind of cool, no one really wants it. That's like pretty much the bottom line. So I want you guys to really, really let me know your thoughts on this in the comment section below. Like, from a gamer's perspective, okay, do you feel like you will be picking this game up, or do you feel like this would come across so much better if they said that the Iron Man VR was basically a joke and hey, this is a new Iron Man game? Don't forget, we have, of course, as far as hero game goes, we've got rumors of the Batman Arkham 2019 game. Then we have that mythical Avengers Project game, of course. And there is also a person making a fan kind of like made Iron Man game, which looks really, really cool. But my point is, this can have a lot of potential, but it seems like Sony and every other game company, for whatever reason, are just kind of ignoring the fact that there's such a big market for this. Because you gotta think about it, even though it might be difficult to get rights, etc., etc., the second you actually do that, will 100% be worth it. Like, flat out, it will be the one, because it's just something that hasn't happened in a long time. The power of consoles now, how you can make it look, and purely how much fun you can have in a game like this, would, I guess, be limitless, right? The sky is your limit, and that would be pretty much down to us as a player and how we decide to play as Iron Man. But I'm not gonna lie, very, very disappointed. I wanted to share my thoughts. It really kind of built up to be an Iron Man unexpected announcement, but hey, we get a VR game. I mean, if you can kind of get rights to do a VR game, why can't you just make a goddamn open world game? You guys get in the comment section below. Let me know what you think on this. That is gonna wrap up this video here. As always, subscribe for more awesome content. I will see you in the next one. Until then, have yourselves a ridiculously amazing day, and adios amigos.